From the campus of Hampton University, where stories are told through the branches of the Emancipation Oak, across the scenic shores of the Hampton River, to all of Hampton Roads, the country, and around the world. WHOV, the Scripps Howard News Watch, starts right now.
Good evening and welcome to WHOV News. I'm Leslie Delaspore.
And I'm Jonathan Scott. Classes are back in session here at Hampton University, and seniors are counting down the days until the May 12th graduation. That'll be the ultimate Mother's Day gift for parents.
Especially mine, because I'm a senior, so I'm super excited about that. This semester will also bring a major conference to the Scripps Howard School of Journalism with award-winning journalists from across the region.
And the school's also preparing to welcome a Little League legend on the campus. Monet Davis has chosen to play softball at HU, and she'll be majoring in journalism at Scripps Howard.
We want to begin the show with a look at the very first day of classes. Hampton students return from winter break with lots of excitement, but the most anxious group is my class, the class of 2019, who are beginning their semester countdown to those final days. Yesterday, students returned from their winter breaks to the hustle and bustle of college life. Students from all classifications are looking forward to making spring 2019 a good semester.
New year, new semester, same school, same students. But for the seniors, they have a lot in store in these classrooms because this is the last time some of them will be walking these halls.
Seniors have a lot to look forward to, like graduation and the return of 100 days next month. Some are even prepared to begin the next phase of their life as their time at Hampton University comes to an end. Just like strategic communications major Eric Dockery, who says he is ready to pursue his career and support his family.
Well, I'm ready to get out of here. You know, I love Hampton, but at the same time, the real world, it's time, you know, make my money, get my family up, and get everybody out the hood. That's the goal.
Even underclassmen are hopeful for the chance to start fresh with the new semester. Freshmen Ashlawn Delaspore and Skylar Bailey both say that they would like to improve academically this semester.
I hope to do way better than first semester, kick my butt. I plan to get like all A's if I can, aiming for the best and highest.
First semester is kind of more of a change period, like going from high school to college. So in that time, I could have done better, so I hope to do a lot better this semester.
These next couple months will be packed with memories and will close out the 2018-2019 academic school year with much success. Leslie Delaspore, WHOV News. And we know the semester has only just begun, but be sure to mark your calendars for Mother's Day, May 12th. That is also my graduation day. Young Monet Davis made history as the first girl to pitch a shutout in the Little League World Series. The softball legend is now looking to score points for Hampton University's team.
She signed a letter of intent to play for the Pirates next season, and she will also be studying journalism. We caught up with the high school senior in between classes at Springside Chestnut Hill Academy in her own hometown of Philadelphia. Here's just a little bit of that conversation.
I love being part of a team. It gives you another family. You never see anyone putting someone else down, and if you do, you see somebody coming in and stopping it, and you just know that you have people that have your back.
Hampton University is like a family, I would say. Everyone's super welcoming, and you can tell it's, everyone cares about each other, and it's just not like a regular college where like you only know a certain amount of people. I feel like everyone knows everybody, and it's just a family atmosphere, which is what I look for in a college.
I came in October for a softball camp, and I got a little peek of it. It wasn't like a full-on tour. And then I wanted to see more, so I came back during homecoming, which is probably one of the best times to come back to see all the alumni and all the current students. And I got a real tour of, like, the dorms, cafeteria, got to watch the football game. So that was fun, and it was I just enjoyed it. I chose softball because it was just what I was having fun with. I mean, I played basketball my entire life, and it just wasn't enjoyable anymore for me at the time. And I knew that if I wanted to do a sport in college, that I had to love the sport and have fun with it, or else it'd become more of a job than a career, and I wouldn't enjoy it as much as I did before. And softball just felt like the right move. I was having a lot of fun with it over the past couple of years, and I feel like I'm going to have fun with it in the next 4 years. I'd say a lot of female athletes inspire me because it's such a hard time at this
point in time to be a woman in sports and to see things that they go through and things that they put up with now and things that they're fighting for girls like me and girls younger than me to have the opportunity and even better than what they have now. So a lot of women athletes inspire me.
As you just saw, Davis's work on the field has landed her on the cover of Sports Illustrated and Time Magazine, named her one of the most 25 most influential teens of 2014.
And we can look forward to her visiting Hampton University and the School of Journalism in the coming weeks.
Hampton University's journalism students will also want to remember April 12th. That's when the National Association of Black Journalists will host its Region 1 conference at the Scripps Howard School of Journalism. Hundreds of media professionals will be on campus for the three-day event. Its theme is Reclaiming Our Story. The conference will help to commemorate the 400th year anniversary of African Americans arriving on American soil as slaves.
Hampton students are politically active and are often seen in the community advocating for different causes. Monday, some traveled to Virginia's capital to support women's rights. The campus chapter of the NAACP and Campus Curls joined dozens of Virginia women in Richmond for the Women's Equality Coalition Lobby Day. Participants viewed upcoming bills on reproductive health care access, and gender discrimination. They met with elected officials like Lieutenant Governor Justin Fairfax and asked questions about where they stand on these upcoming bills. And this isn't the only major statewide news in the headlines.
The Virginia House has just passed a bill to increase its minimum wage to $15. This comes after dozens of women rallied at the Capitol Monday. If the measure passes, SB 1200 will take effect July 1st with gradual increases. It will climb to 10 an hour, and then in 2020, it goes up to 13 an hour. It will finally reach $15 an hour in 2021. The bill will now advance to the full Senate for a vote. Trump's Attorney General nominee faced Senate hearing today. William Barr prepared a testimony saying he would let special counsel Robert Mueller finish his investigation of the 2016 presidential election. Barr said that Russia is a potent rival of our country and has no doubt that Russians attempted to meddle in the U.S. election. Barr concerned that the fixation on Russia could obscure the danger from China.
My goal will be to provide as much transparency as I can, consistent with the law. I can assure you that where judgments are to be made, I will make those judgments based solely on the law, and I will not let personal, political, or other improper interests influence my decision.
Some of our favorite fast foods have made it to the White House. Yesterday evening, President Trump decided fast foods such as McDonald's and Wendy's would be the perfect celebratory meal for the Clemson Tigers football team. The Tigers recently won their second national football title after defeating the Alabama Crimson Tide. Way to celebrate a championship meal.
Now taking a look at what mess and mayhem your favorite celebrities are in this week.
Our entertainment reporter Mackenzie Walker is here with the scoop. Mackenzie?
Thanks, guys. Blac Chyna and Alexis Sky are at odds. Ariana Grande gets a Pokemon tattoo, and Meghan Markle is finally showing off her baby bump. Entertainment news starts right now. Get your popcorn and get ready. It may not be Wednesday, but Rob Kardashian is definitely showing off his WCW earlier this week. The former Keeping Up with the Kardashians star reportedly posted a picture of Love and Hip Hop star Alexis Sky, the enemy of ex-girlfriend Blac Chyna. Rob posted a screenshot of Sky with the caption, "My WCW, I've been wanting you for so long." This escalated to a heated altercation at a private party in Los Angeles. Ariana Grande gets a Pokemon tattoo after playing the game for 15 hours. The Thank You Next singer posted a picture of a black and gray portrait of Pokemon star Eevee, which is inked on the inside of her left bicep. Hours before posting the tat, the Nickelodeon star admitted that she spent most of her day playing Pokemon on her Nintendo Switch. 5 months after their fabulous wedding, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex announced that they were pregnant during their royal tour. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry will be expecting a baby in spring 2019. The Kensington Palace announced that the couple is grateful for the support they have received from people around the world. They are delighted to share this news with the public. On Monday, the Duchess started some clues about her due date and is keeping the baby's gender a surprise. R. Kelly's record label has put his music on hold since the surviving R. Kelly backlash. Sony has put his new music on hold until the criminal investigations are resolved. R. Kelly is reportedly upset because he has been in the studio recording new music to fulfill the obligations under this new contract, which requires two new albums from him. The stars didn't waste any time making headlines this week. That's it for entertainment. I'm Mackenzie Walker. Back to you guys at the desk.
And coming up in the show, we'll take a look at how the economy and the largest city might be decreasing in size.
And later on, we'll be talking with Hampton's own Dr. Warren Jones about how the new Caribbean Health Initiative that he and the university are spearheading. Stay with us.
At the beginning of 2016, I was diagnosed with a pretty large brain tumor and a very rare form of brain cancer. We came to the conclusion that proton therapy was the best solution for me because as a young woman, we wanted to preserve as much of my brain as we could without treating areas that weren't affected by the cancer cells. Proton therapy spared my quality of life. It put a smile back on my face that I hadn't seen in months.
Live your life. Let the Hampton University Proton Therapy Institute fight your cancer.
Hey, look, it's those guys.
Get some drinks!
Are you good to drive?
I'm fine.
How many did you have?
I should be fine.
You should be?
Go ahead and step out of the vehicle for me.
See ya, buddy. Good luck.
So turns out, buzz driving and drunk driving, they're the same thing. And it costs around $10,000. So not worth it.
How are you today?
Good.
I'm here to talk about how with technology you can make amazing worlds. Come with me. My team and I bring the Halo world to life.
Is that you?
That is me. I wasn't a math genius and I knew nothing about coding. But you guys do. You guys have the power to change things.
I want your job.
I want you to have my job.
Welcome back to WHOV News. Student loan debt tops this week's business news.
And we turn to Kennedy Buck at the Bloomberg Business Terminal for that story and today's other business headlines. Kennedy?
Thank you, Leslie and Jonathan. Let's get started with your Bloomberg Business Report. If you're counting down the days until graduation and getting worried about paying back those student loans, well, you're not alone. The U.S. student loan debt climbed to $1.4 trillion in the last quarter of 2018. Bloomberg analysts show students who borrowed in 2012 are having the hardest time repaying their student loans because they entered the workforce right after the recession. At that time, the unemployment rate was double what it is today. Fears of another recession could mean problems for our generation of college graduates. The Big Apple may be moving south. Or at least a lot of the city's residents are. Bloomberg census data suggests more people are moving to Dallas than any other city in the country. An average of 246 people are moving to the city daily. At the same time, more than 100 people are leaving New York City every day. Business analysts say this can mean a big loss of skill and money for NYC. There are tiny signs that America's trade war with China is easing up. Talks wrapped in Beijing last Wednesday, and there's no new meeting scheduled. But the U.S. did release a statement saying China has agreed to buy more goods from the U.S., including agricultural goods, energy, and manufactured products. China also released a statement expressing optimism for a resolution, and global stocks rose on Wednesday off the heels of this optimism. Well, that's it from us today from the Bloomberg Terminal. I'm Kennedy Buck. Back to you guys at the desk.
Here's a quick look at today's Wall Street numbers. The Dow closed at 24,000 with an increase of 155 points. The Nasdaq closed at a little over 7,000 with an increase of 117 points.
The S&P closed at 2,000 points, and that's all we have.
Well, today we have a special guest with us, Dr. Warren Jones, the Chief Health Officer here at Hampton University. And Dr. Jones, thank you for joining us. Thank you
very much, Leslie. And Jonathan, thank you for the opportunity to be here.
Thank you for coming.
Well, let's go ahead and we just want to jump right into it.
Yes.
So we really want to know about the Caribbean Health Initiative. That's, you know, brand new thing that you just started recently. Tell us more about it.
Well, fortunately here at Hampton University, our leadership is visionary. President Harvey decided a while back that Hampton University needed to be the place where the experts in the world will be trained on dealing with research and conditions and programs that lead to the elimination of health disparities. One of the areas of the world that he looked at was the Caribbean. They have some of the worst outcomes from certain types of diseases, cancer, breast cancer, cervical cancer, from heart disease, diabetes, and complications. So he studied how we could go about making a difference, and we came up with the concept of a Center for Caribbean Health Research. It was launched on April 1st, and we're in the process of putting the programming together, and we'll be hosting our first annual conference in April of this year.
Wow, that is really, April 1st, that's not that long ago. That's exciting, but you guys have made really good progress.
Yes.
It seems like that's really exciting. It's yes. Really exciting.
What are some of the health issues that are at least facing the Black community right now? And I mean, as far as we're concerned, young college students, how do we stay ahead of that curve and keep ourselves healthy?
I'm so glad, Jonathan, you asked that question, because many years ago, people your ages didn't have to worry about things such as diabetes and high blood pressure. But now those are mainstays of conditions that you have to face. So one of the things that we're going to be doing through the Minority Men's Health Initiative, we have got a blood pressure machine that will be that we're going to place in the student center. That students will be able to go over there, take their blood pressure, and record it, and have a good sense of where they are. They'll be able to participate in their wellness. We would encourage you, go by there, take that picture, get that sense of your blood pressure, and get a good feel for where you are. It'll help you to monitor your health and help you to help your family members know how to take care of themselves.
Well, just really quickly, if you don't mind answering this, a lot of our audience members probably want to get involved, or, you know, so what is one way that they can get involved? Do they contact you? Do they go to the health center, you know, with the initiative, or, you know, other things that you're a part of?
Well, we're still in the formative stages with the Caribbean Health Initiative.
Okay.
So we're going to be reaching out to students to be a part of our conference. We invite the students who are working with researchers on campus to ask them if they're involved with either the Minority Men's Health Initiative or some of the programs from the center. And we welcome students all together, all the time.
Great.
Interestingly enough, we've got students here from all over the Caribbean. And we would like to ask the student Caribbean student organization to be a part of our efforts. We think this is a wonderful opportunity to make a difference.
Well, thank you. Thank you for joining us, and thank you for giving us this valuable information. I'm sure all the students watching will pass this on to their friends, and hopefully it'll become a big thing on the campus.
Thank you for the opportunity to be here.
Thank you. Coming up next here on WHOV, winter weather has blanketed half of the country. This week, see why forecasters say we may need to brace ourselves for bitter cold and snow.
And it was a storm on the court when the Hampton Pirates took on UNC's Bulldogs. Stay tuned for the final score and some unforgettable highlights. We'll be right back.
Because of you, I felt hopeless.
I know it was a joke, but it still hurt me.
Because of you, I felt wanted and not alone in this world.
Because you said hi to me on the first day of school, I felt included and I knew that I was going to be okay.
My name's Mark, I'm an alcoholic.
Dorothy T, and I am an alcoholic.
For so long, alcohol has sort of been there for me to sort of see me through social situations.
Drinking was more important than anything else. My journey in AA started years ago when I reached the outside limits of my desperation.
I really wanted to quit drinking. I just couldn't stop on my own. And you know, I remember when I woke up on the day that I got sober. I felt something inside of me tell me that I could go to AA.
These people, you know, just gathered around me. That was the fellowship in action in my life.
The moral of my story today is that AA has never let me down, ever.
If I carry any sort of message with my story, it's that, you know, keep coming back and that this thing does work.
If you have a problem with alcohol, contact AA. It works.
I thought that tumor was gone, that we already took care of it.
The type of tumor that he has was wrapped around his brainstem, and
Once Lana recovered from the surgery, we just put our faith in the proton radiation therapy to get the balance of the tumor because we knew how precise and successful the proton radiation therapy had been.
I'm feeling a lot better, and I'm glad my hair is going back.
Live your life. Let the Hampton University Proton Therapy Institute fight your cancer.
Winter is here, but a wonderland, I'm not too sure about that. The snowstorms are frigid, the temperatures are not for frolicking in the snow with Frosty, if you know what I mean.
Exactly, Leslie. I don't leave home without a coat.
Right.
But thankfully, our weather correspondent, Carmen Jackson, is here in the studio to helpfully bring us some more sunshine and a little less rain, sleet, and snow. Carmen?
Thanks, Jonathan and Leslie. Let's get right into it. My name is Carmen Jackson, and let's get right into the weather. I hope you are bundled up for today's weather. We experienced partly cloudy skies with a high of 43 degrees and a low of 30. Tomorrow, you can expect your day to warm up a bit. We will see mostly sunny skies throughout the day with a high of 50 degrees and a low of 33. Thursday, the temperature will drop to 46, but luckily, your weekend will begin with a high of 55 on Friday and a high of 48 on Saturday. You will want to bring out those umbrellas for Sunday. There will be early morning showers with mild winds throughout the day. The sun will be back on Monday, but it's still going to be chilly with 31 degrees. You will want to stay bundled up with your umbrellas right by your side, just in case you forgot. It is winter and those cold temperatures are not going anywhere just yet. That's a look at your forecast. Try and stay warm for at least the next 10 days. Leslie and Jonathan, back to you.
Coming up, we'll take a look at what Little League star is making Hampton University her new home by the sea.
I had myself examined and they came to the conclusion that, yes, I did have prostate cancer. At the Hampton University Proton Therapy Institute, I didn't experience any pain or side effects whatsoever. I feel great. The proton therapy here saved my life. They say there's 7 wonders of the world. Well, this is the 8th.
Live your life. Let the Hampton University Proton Therapy Institute fight.
They call me Prince like I'm royalty or something. But the places I've lived ain't no palaces. So I don't need grilled salmon or a new scratching post. Just give me a cardboard box and a can of tuna and we're good. You can even change my name. I'm cool being the kitty formerly known as Prince.
Hey, Bobo. Do trees tell each other stories?
I'm sorry. I'm afraid I don't know that.
Hey, why don't we go find out? Listen.
Drop that baby.
Welcome back to WHOV News. Hampton's athletes are back on the work on the field and on the court.
Sports director Harrington Gardner is here with a look at what's going on with our home teams and the rest of the world of sports. Harrington?
Thanks, Leslie and Jonathan. Let's get right into it. We begin with men's basketball, where the Pirates begin this semester with a pretty big win. Sports reporter Tatiana Wilson has the highlights.
Students, faculty, and Hampton Nation fans from across Hampton Roads packed the Convocation Center Saturday for the HU Blue and U game. The Hamptons men's basketball team faced the regular season defending champs, UNC Asheville. Both teams had a slow start with neither scoring in the first couple possessions. In this play, Akeem Mitchell goes for a deep corner three, followed by another corner three on the next possession. That puts the Pirates on the board and in the lead. It's a lead they hold for the first half. UNC puts forth a valiant effort, but the Bulldogs aren't able to slow down the Pirates' offense. The Pirates are up big at the half with 49-25. And at the top of the second half, the Pirates continue to dominate. Jermaine Merrill carries this Hampton team. He was recently ranked number 5 in the country in scoring. We see big plays from transfer DeAndre Griffin. He's usually a 6th man for the Pirates, but he becomes the lead scorer in this game, earning a spot in the starting lineup. We catch up with Pirates shooting guard Kalen Fisher after the big game. With Kalen Fisher, shooting guard for the Pirates, and if you guys don't know, as of Thursday night, Kalen has joined the 1,000 point club, making him the 30th Hampton player in history to join the 1,000 point club. So, I mean, can you just talk about that and what that means for you?
It just means hard work pays off. Basically, for me, I've been here for 4 years, so you know, I've just been going hard, doing my thing, basically. So.
I'm Tatiana Wilson, WHOV News.
Thank you to Tatiana for showcasing that story. Let's keep up the good work, Pirates. The road to the Super Bowl continues in Kansas City and in New Orleans this Sunday. First, Tom Brady and the Patriots will be traveling on the road in the AFC title game to take on Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs. Both these teams are coming off impressive wins in the divisional round. Then the final championship game will include the Los Angeles Rams and the New Orleans Saints in the Superdome down in Louisiana. It should be a high-scoring affair. All four of these teams are the highest-scoring offenses in the NFL. These two conference championship matchups are rematches of this year's regular season meetings. Sunday is sure to be a good day for football, and we'll finally see who is going to go advance to the Super Bowl. There's uncertainty in Pittsburgh for Steelers wide receiver Antonio Brown. There are rumors the star receiver is being shopped to another team. The talk comes after several disputes with head coach Mike Tomlin and starting quarterback Ben Roethlisberger. Antonio Brown also hasn't returned phone calls from the Steelers organization. But owner Art Rooney II is talking. He says, "I find it hard to see Brown suiting up as a Steeler come training camp in July." Brown has expressed heavy interest in the San Francisco 49ers, following them on social media, and liking several photos from players on the team. Turning on to the NBA now, the All-Star Game is fast approaching. It's taking place in February in beautiful Charlotte, North Carolina. In the Western Conference, the leaders for the front court include LeBron James, Kevin Durant, and rookie sensation Luka Doncic. The guards include MVP players Stephen Curry, James Harden, and Russell Westbrook. In the backcourt, Derrick Rose is one of the leading vote-getters to make the All-Star team, with his impressive performances this season. Rose had a career-high 50-point performance on Halloween night and was one of the highlights of the NBA this season. In the Eastern Conference, the front court leaders include Giannis Antetokounmpo, Kawhi Leonard, Joel Embiid, and Jason Tatum. The guards include Kyrie Irving, Kemba Walker, Ben Simmons, and Dwayne Wade, who is playing in his last NBA season. If Wade makes the All-Star team this year, it will be a crowning achievement to a Hall of Fame-worthy career. In case you missed the news, the former Little League star Monet Davis is coming to Hampton University. The standout female softball player has signed her letter of intent to play for the Pirates following a more than successful Little League career and high school career. Davis pitched in the 2014 Little League World Series and is known for being the first girl in history to pitch a shutout game. She has received multiple accolades, including an ESPY, and Time magazine named Davis one of the top 25 most influential teens of 2014. She makes her Pirates debut in the fall. That does it for sports, but make sure to stay tuned to find out some of our very own WHOV family will be a part of sports history. Jonathan and Leslie, back to you guys at the desk.
Coming up, we'll talk about two lucky members of our team that will be heading down to Atlanta in just a few weeks.
Don't go anywhere. You don't want to miss this one.
It's always a big planet.
When I was your age, I was just like you, fascinated by stars.
Wow.
But now I get to search for life in the universe. And who knows? Maybe life is looking for us, too.
So we're like aliens to them?
Yeah. Does anyone want to be a scientist now?
I do.
Awesome. We need more girls in STEM.
Maybe we can find aliens.
I was diagnosed with cancer of the left breast. I was never given the option of proton therapy. Fortunately for me, my sister had just toured the facility at the Hampton University Proton Therapy Institute. The beam was able to target my tumor precisely without affecting my heart or lungs. After treatment, I'm living my best life.
Live your life. Let the Hampton University Proton Therapy Institute fight your cancer.
It's a big responsibility.
Oh, it's huge. I know, it's huge.
And the salary.
Oh my God, yes. Right? I mean, like, I was about to move in with my parents, and right before, yeah, so this saved me.
I really believe in you, you know?
Thank you, it's nice to hear that from someone.
These are cool. Did you,
Well, before we close out the show, we wanted to make a very big announcement here at WHOV. Myself and Jonathan Scott and our awesome director, Carlton Griffin, will be traveling to the Super Bowl down in Atlanta in just a few weeks. I obtained press credentials from the NFL for the third time, and I'm lucky enough to have a number of press credentials to take my colleagues with me, and I'm super duper excited. Are you excited, Jonathan? You ready?
I am ecstatic. Bringing all my jerseys and everything. We're gonna get great shots. Can't wait to put a package together to you guys.
Right. I think it's gonna be a good opportunity for like us as journalists to go. And I think for me, it's awesome that the NFL like really recognizes us as students.
Absolutely.
And the fact that they even gave us press credentials, because for the third time, we're still gonna be the only college students there. So I think that's really, really awesome that they did that for us. So shout out to you and Carlton and myself, and stay with us in the next 2 weeks and keep updated on, you know, what's going to be happening. So,
alrighty.
Well, that's all we have for this evening here at WHOV. I'm Leslie Delaspore.
And I'm Jonathan Scott. Good night.